Yes, thank you. About me, you all already know this, so I'm skipping this part from yesterday. What is the agenda of this talk? First, I will give a short look back at the JCI content loader and how you can use it to package your applications and deploy your applications and have a different model of setting up your Maven projects. And then the main part of this talk is about the file system resource provider, which eases the development with applications built in this fashion. Some special features on both of them, limitations of this approach and the comparison with other approaches like using Sling IDE or AAM Eclipse integration, and a conclusion. And the goal of all this is just making it easier to develop AAM applications, an alternative approach shown today. So let's start with the JCR content loader. You all have it available because it's included for years in both Sling and AAM, and it's not so often used, but it works pretty well. What is it? The JCR content loader supports loading JCR content from OSGI bundles. That means the OSGI bundle contains JCR content, and this is installed to the repository when the bundle is installed. And the content is normally, the other formats available as well, stored as JSON inside the bundle. So somehow this is an alternative to AAM packages for application content. It's not really useful for other types of content like content pages or assets or whatever, but for application content, it works really well. This is a picture to visualize this. This is the OSGI bundle on the left side, which just contains, additionally to the Java classes, a set of JSON files or perhaps binary files, something else, whatever. And there's a special header in this bundle. And when this bundle gets deployed, this header is detected, and the JCR content loader extracts the content from the OSGI bundle and stores it into the JCR repository. And to make this work, you have to put a special header in your bundle. And this is an example using configuring it using the Maven bundle plugin. It's called Sling Initial Content, this header. And this has a special syntax in this case, simple variant. The first path part, Sling Inf AppRoot, is where the JSON files are stored in the class path of the OSGI bundle. You can use any path you want, just you have to put the correct one in the header. In this case, I have set override true to make sure that if the target path in the repository already exists, it's cleaned and replaced with a new content from the bundle. And the last path, the last part is a path attribute property to say the target path. So if I deploy this bundle and it gets installed, all content from the bundle is placed into apps, my app in this case. And there it's just plain JCR content with nodes, properties, and perhaps binary files, the same as you would do, it would look like if you have installed it using an AAM package. What is the advantage of doing this? First, you have the possibility to combine your whole application or part, module of application, in a single Maven project. You do not have to do the split up with one for the bundle and one for the application content, holding your scripts and dialog differences, etc. You can put all into one single Maven project. Like I show you an example in the next slide. And my personal opinion is that this JSON format is much more compact and better readable than the even human readable file-walled XML. And for example, you can omit most of the primary type definitions if they are inherited from the parent node type. Most times they are anti-unstructured anyway. You can just omit them and making it even more readable and more easier maintainable. To show a short example, I will show you a project that is built in this style. Just switching to screen duplication. So here I have a demo project, which is available on GitHub as well. I will show you the URL at the end of the slides. And here I have one OSGI project, just bundle core project, containing both some Java classes and content. And I have additional traditional firewall project only holding my sample content, my sample pages to show the application and the parent. That's not relevant here. Having a look at this core bundle, it's a normal OSGI bundle project just containing two Java classes, Sling models in this case. And then I have an additional folder, source main web app, where I have in this case multiple subfolders which target different paths in my repository. Let's have a look into the POM. Here I have my Sling initial content definition. In this case, I have four target paths pointing to different root paths in my application. This is the main path, my application. Then I have a special path for internationalization files because I need some special translation for them to be processed correctly. I have a path for my client lib, and in this case, I have also a design page. It's an old styled application, not yet using the template editor, but it's compatible with 6.1 to 6.3 AM versions, so I've used this. So this is my definition where do the different paths are copied to. And let's have a look in the main path. For example, I have my template definition, just defining the title and path, etc. I have my page component. It's just inheriting from the old style foundation page component. Because again, 6.1, 6.2, 6.3 compatibility. If you use 6.3, please use the new core components. They are much better than the foundation components. And then my scripts, or example, a content component, for example, a teaser component. In one file, I have my component definition, edit configuration, HTML tag configuration, and dialog definition, and all quite neatly formatted without too much boilerplate code around, and my scripts, of course, as you would expect them. Yes, and if I want to deploy this, I can use, as usual, the Maven Sling plugin, just doing Maven Sling install, which deploys your OSGI bundle, or using a complete package, can show you this as well. In this case, I have a very small Maven content package plugin project which just embeds my OSGI bundle. In this case, I'm referencing it and embedding it here, but on the end, it's just an AM package with one OSGI bundle included, and okay, to dependencies in this case to have the internationalization example working, but mainly it's my application bundle, which contains, I can have a look into this bundle as well, just my JSON files and all that is included in the Sling-in folders, and of course my Java classes all in one bundle. Okay, and now I have this project. I can deploy it, but what I cannot do is using the Eclipse EDE or Sling EDE integration, because it's not a firewall project. It has a completely other layout. It uses JSON instead of XML, and it's all packaged in one Maven project. So I can use, to still have an instant feedback of all my changes and doing the repository, I can use a file system resource provider. This was also available for really a lot of years already. It was always in the Sling Quick Start, but not in AAM, because you usually do not need it on production, but only in your development instances. I did some, a lot of extensions and some additions over the last 12 months. So what you see today is relatively new concerning some of those features. What is it doing? It mounts a file system path on your local hard disk into the Sling resource hierarchy, completely bypassing JCR and awk. So you see a new tree, new subtree in your Sling hierarchy, and it also works for scripts and for most parts of AM, but it does not come from the JCR, but it's coming from the file system. And all files, it's finding there, it's just mapping them to ntfold and ntfile nodes. But if it finds JSON files, and this initial content header is present, then the JSON files are automatically parsed and mapped to real resources and properties in your resource hierarchy. So basically, the file system resource provider is doing the same as the Sling content loader, but it does not copy the content on deploying the bundle, but it's just mounting it and mirroring the file system in your resource hierarchy, which means if you change any file on your file system, it's reflected immediately in your AAM instance. It also supports the FileVault XML layout, so if you want to use a file system resource provider with your traditional setup FileVault application, this works as well. Just an image to visualize it again. Here I have my AAM instance running in my OSGI container, AAM and Sling, and the JCR repository, and one subpath I'm mounting from my file system. And there's no synchronization, there's no copying, it's really just a mount. And you can use any IDE to edit your Maven project because you do not need any plugin in your IDE. It's just mounting the file system, and you can use IDEA or Eclipse or Sublime or Emacs or whatever to edit your project. So you do not need an IDE plugin. Changes get visible immediately. Of course, you still have to do a refresh in your browser. It's no direct sync. And the benefit of having no synchronization between file system and JCR is A, it's faster, and B, it cannot get corrupt. Because if you have synchronization like in the Sling IDE Eclipse integration, it's doing a file-by-file synchronization. So when you change one file, it's uploaded and it's updated, which works perfect. But if you're doing more complex things like refactoring your whole subtree of your application, moving it, renaming it, etc., in your IDE, things get more complicated, and the diffs that have to be pushed to the AAM instance can get out of sync somehow. And this type of problems you cannot have with the file system resource provider. You have other limitations, I will show them later, but not no synchronization problems or delays. How do you enable this? If you have AAM, I've told it already, by default, the bundle of the file system resource provider is not installed in your AAM instance, which is correct, and which makes sense for production instance, but on your local developer instance, you need it. To make it easier to just enable it for your local instance, there's a small addition in the Maven Sling plugin, and you're just doing Sling FS mount. I'm showing this to you on this project. I'm going to my bundle project, just making the font bit bigger. And yes, and now I'm just doing Sling MFN Sling FS mount. And what it's now doing is first checking my local my local Maven project, parsing the POM, looking for a Sling initial content header, taking its configuration, and automatically creating an OSGI configuration in the instance, in the local DevM instance, for mapping the path. And additionally, if the required bundles for the FS resource are not deployed and it's dependencies like Johnson jar, they are uploaded as well. So in this case, the plugin downloaded the necessary files from artifact, which are not on this machine available, adding the configuration, uploading the bundles, and if I now look into my web console, I have the Apache Sling file system resource provider available, and if I look into the configuration, there are my four paths from the project neatly mapped, and if I look into it, it's have taken the correct local path, the provider route, the correct mode, supporting also JSON files, and the properties with override and ignoring special import providers, etc. So you do not have to set up this manually, just use the Sling FS mount, or if you want to remove the configuration, use sling fs unmount, then the configuration is removed again on your project, which makes it really easy to just set it up on a fresh AAM instance. And and now I'm showing you for what's this use. I'm opening my demo application. Just going to the homepage. It's just a small bootstrap example with some editable components. What I can, of course, do is just changing the script, which is easy and which was possible for years with the resource provider. Just starting with the stage teaser, for example, and changing this headline from H1 to H3, and then I have a smaller. If I edit. Okay, I'm in the correct. Okay, there's some strange thing in the styling here, but I've added just some words to the script and they popped up as expected. There's some styling of overwriting the H1 to H3 styling. Okay, so this works, this was easy. Next thing, I want to change the edit dialog. Here I have an edit dialog with title, text, button, etc. And this is here in the stage teaser JSON, and I just want to, for example, add an additional field, perhaps a second title in my edit dialog, storing it with title 2. And then I will display it as well in a second line and add it here. And okay, I did not even have to refresh, but now it's here, title 2. To show it, I will edit it again and just change the to title 2A or whatever, and it's directly loaded, and so I can directly edit the dialog definitions as well. And this works for nearly all things in your AM application. Changes are immediately reflected without any synchronization, just by mounting your file system. This, of course, works for all static files, for your client libs, JSON fragments, and also for IATN files if you're using the new mode where the IATN translations are stored in a JSON file as well. And it also works for FileVault layout projects. Some special features of both, of the content loader and the file system resource provider. You have the ability to decide when you deploy your bundle to overwrite or merge the content. If you do overwrite, then all existing data on apps, my app folder, for example, is deleted and replaced. If you do it merge, then it's only new data is copied into it. So it's seldomly used for applications, but you can use it. You can add special descriptor files. For example, you need it for the JSON IATN files. They need a special mix-in on the NTFile node. And you can put an additional XML file to it and add this mix-in so the files get correctly detected by the IATN implementation of Sling. You can, if you have special file names not allowed in your local file system, especially on Windows, it's quite limited, you can use UL encoding. You can also set ACLs on your on your content structures and register node types. Coming to the file system resource provider, we have three modes. The first and simple mode was available for years, just mounting files and folders. And the second and third modes are new, relatively new, supporting also this JSON content fragment and this XML files and our complete file system layout with content packages. I can show you this as well. If I'm going to my sample content package, which is just a traditional file system layout with JSON root, etc., you know it. Then I go here to the content package and say as well, and sling fs mount. And now it's setting up an additional configuration just for this project. And I'm going back to my sample application. now my data is not longer present because now I've loaded it from the file system. And if I'm now going to my file system and directly change something in the file system or IDE or whatever, my EN page, oh, hopefully it's working. Yes, then I'm just going here to a warm welcome here, a warm welcome, hoo-hoo, and going back and then, yeah. It doesn't make really sense for sample content, but if your application is structured using just a firewalled application, which is most times the case because this is the default used by the AIM archetype or the lazybones setup, so this works as well. There's also a cache for past content fragments, which is just limited by a number, configurable number, for example, 1,000 fragments by default, an in-memory cache, which gets automatically invalidated if the file changes on the file system. And yes, and it respects the different sling initial content parameters you put in your POM. It has also support for eventing, which is important for a lot of features which rely on eventing. So every time a file changes on the file system, it sends resource events using the sling resource eventing mechanism. And all services listening on this gets notified and, for example, can clear their caches, script caches, etc. And it has a mocked JCR API support. So if some application gets a file system resource mounted from the file system and then tries to adapt this JCR, which normally would result in null or an old node perhaps still present in the JCR and not the correct node, the file system resource provider gives back a simulated node instance with properties and et cetera, and you can do everything with it, save you cannot write, it's read-only, and you cannot use observation and so on, but you can access it. The reason is that a lot of code of AIM around the authoring still uses the JCR IPA, so it would just break with the file system resource provider, and with this trick, hack, this still works a lot, the most of things are working. Yes, and this supports all Sling versions 7, 8, 9, AM 6.1, best 6.3. I have not tested this 6.0 perhaps, it's still working as well. And but if you want to lose a special mode with XML descriptors for JSON ITN files, you have to use the latest JCR content loader version 2.3, I think, which is part of AM 6.4, but not yet in 6.3, at least not without any service packs. But you can just replace it on deployment, and then it works as well. Yeah, what are limitations? We have limitations. It's not a perfect world. Services that rely on JCR observation do not get notified on changes. We have two different notification mechanisms. We have it in Sling, and we have it in JCR. And Sling is working because we are a Sling resource provider, but JCR is not working because we have no contact to JCR. It's just a mount completely bypassing the repository. And so some features in AM are not working. For example, the HTML library manager, which is processing your client libs, gets not notified if your CSS or JavaScript files changes. An easy workaround is just to, for example, use the debug client libs true statement, because in this case it's bypassing for a good part the HTML library manager and directly includes the different files, and then changes are reflected. Perhaps you are using this anyway most times to have easier debugging of your scripts. And another a bit nasty point is the AIM component registry, which also has a cache relying on JCR observation. That means a new component you are adding is not immediately visible in the component browser, for example. Changes to decoration tags, like doing a different tag name or adding past CSS classes, are not directly visible. In this case, the only workaround is to deploy the bundle or in some other way clear this cache. I've been thinking a while for easy integration to somehow simulate JCR observation events as well, but it's not easy. So currently this is a limitation. This is by design, resources are read-only. You cannot write back to the file system because we do not need it. And one tiny issue where you see this, if you have thumbnails for your thumbnails for your templates, for example, then AAM is automatically writing back to the application path a scaled down version of the thumbnail for displaying it. And this does not work when the resource tree is read only, so this template thumbnail is not displayed when you have switched on the file system resource, but this is only a cosmetic problem. As soon as you switch it off, it's visible again. Yeah, and if you compare, I've told you that using Sling, the JCR content loader, is somehow comparable to AAM content packages. But AAM content packages can do much more, which is not always relevant for application content, but it's much relevant for other content packages. So in AAM content packages, you have your filter XML, which is a very complex beast, and you can do a lot of things with it. You can not only include paths, but you can also add a list of includes and excludes and configure merge settings, etc. And this granularity of filtering is not possible with the content loader. You have some possibility override merging and multiple paths, but not all this fine-grained control. Content packages offer support for merge handling for ACLs. So if your content package contains ACLs, you can configure it to not completely override the existing ones, but just add new ones. This is only possible with content packages currently. And the JCR content loader, so when you deploy your bundle, contains some type of firewalled XML layout, but only with a special file system layout, which is not compatible with AAM packages. So for most cases, you still will still be using AAM packages, they're good. But for application content, the Sling JCR content loader together with the file system resource provider is a really good alternative. And another limitation is you have no automatic sync back, which is for parts of an application important. For example, if you are using design mode and template editor, and if you do not want to leave the editing of templates completely to your customers, because perhaps they are not so deep in AAM as you are, so maybe your development team is also preparing a set of editable templates or design modes and shipping it with the application. And in this case, with content packages, it's easy because you can just package it, download it, putting it in your source code management system, and you're ready. It is, of course, possible to express editable templates in design mode in AAM applications, but if you use the GUI tools to just edit your templates and design mode, then you have to manually sync it back, for example, using the Sling get servlet and saving the file, and this is not really convenient. My recommendation in this case is it's easy because editable templates in design mode are not really belonging to the application content. They are something in between real content and application. So just use a separate firewalled project for those, which you can upload, download, and sync. And it still makes sense to use Sling initial content JCR loader and the JSON layout for your application contents, which is your scripts, your dialog definitions, etc. Just a short comparison. This is, again, the file system resource provider, AAM repository. The provider bypasses the repository and directly mounts from the file system, and you can use any IDE. And if you compare this to the Sling EDE or AAM EDE integration Eclipse, then it's looking like this. You have your AAM instance, your repository, and you have your file system provider and Eclipse, because officially no other variant is available with the plug-in. And any change that is done here is copied on a file-by-file basis to the repository. And also, you can do an import, in this case, the whole folder using special command in your IDE, and then it's downloaded here. So this is the difference between this is just bypasses mounting it, and this is really doing a file-by-file synchronization. And this can get sometimes into trouble if you're doing really complex things. It's easy to fix because then, okay, just download all, upload all again, and then it's in sync again, but it's a bit yeah, it's not so nice when it's get auto-sync, which happens seldom, but this can happen. And this part is a support by the SlingED, which is not supported at all by file and source provider. If you change any class in your OSGI bundles, the Sling IDE integration has support to automatically deploy your bundle to OSGI with a special mode mounting your classes folder. This is not supported. Perhaps this will be in some days available separately to use only this and not in combination with the content sync. But this is out of the scope for this talk. Yes, do you have other more alternatives, for example, which are related to which I've shown here? You have the Apache Sling bundle resource provider. This was also available for really a lot of time, but it was got recently some improvements. But in my opinion, it's currently feasible only for simple use cases. It currently does not support all features from JCR Content Loader, like special escaping and coding things, and it has no support, as far as I know, for any eventing. So if some code relies on Sling eventing, it will not work with the Sling bundle resource provider. And if we talk about easy tools for yes, supporting your local AM application development and syncing between your file system and the repository, there's also another quite unknown tool, Repo, from Alexander Klimicek, and it's a FTP-like tool for firewalled XML JCR content synchronization. I have a link, you can have a look at it. It has its own philosophy as well. But it basically, it just on the fly creates the packages and pushes it up to the AM instance in the fastest possible way and bypassing also some special features. This is just a comparison. I will not go into all details here because I'm already 2 minutes over time. You can look at it in the floats just to make it short what is not possible. If you have firewalled, you can do nearly everything. The Adobe recommended way, but you cannot have a single application project and you have to live with the quite verbose XML structure. With the Sling JSR content, you can nearly do anywhere as well. You have a bit nicer readable application files, but there are some limitations like filtering, merge handling, and currently there's no archetype for it. But if you can live with those limitations, it's a good way. And the Sling bundle resource provider is useful for simple use cases, but not for all here. And if you compare the different ways to sync your local file system with your repository or your AM instance, then using the Adobe recommended way, firewall XML Eclipse IDE, you can do nearly everything. Some features, Nikola here is a bug. ACLs are currently not supported, just will break where it have a note with ACLs. Currently, it's an open ticket. Perhaps it will be fixed soon. You have sometimes perhaps sync problems. I'm not sure if you have encountered them as well. I'm not. And it's currently not supported by all IDEs, but only by Eclipse. There was some work on having it in IDEA as well, but I'm not sure how far this had gotten. And here you have nearly all synchronization, but you have no JC observations, which is in the AM has some limitations, I've already told. And not all filters supported. And with the repo tool, yes, you have to call it. It's no automatic visibility of changes. Of course, you can configure a shortcut in your IDE, but it also has some limitations like no filtering support and ACLs. I'm not sure. Yeah, so what is inclusions? Yeah, you as a developer have a lot of options what you can use. Firewall, content loader, repo tool, etc. And sometimes a bit difficult to really evaluate and what is the best for your project. It's easy to say that the firewall and the Sling IDE is recommended by Adobe and the de facto standard because it's used in all archetypes and it's a good way. There's no hard reason to not use it because it's used by most applications, but yeah, still we are using this other way, content loader and file system resource provider for years, and are very happy with that as well. So you just can choose what is the best for your project. And yeah, the demo project is here, the documentation and the different tooling you find in the slides. Okay, that's.
So, thank you, Stefan. Any questions? Here's one in the front, Masoud.
Hello. I have a question regarding testing and deploying test content for integration tests. What would the preferred method to be, the resource provider or the content loader, when we are testing with Sling JUnit and Teleporter?
I've never used it in this combination. You mean to save the time to deploy the package, to make it faster, or?
No, we have special content for each test case, and we need to erase the content after the test has run.
It could work. You make have to make sure that it's not the test do not run in parallel, because you have always mounted only one path and not multiple that are conflicting, but it could work, but I've never used it in this combination.
Could work if we would use the resource provider.
Yeah.
And the content loader, would it also be possible to use the content loader to deploy it with in the
I think so, yes. If you use the teleporter to deploy your bundle with a fragment of test content, it should work. Yeah, I suppose so. Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. We will try that.
Yep.
Thank you. Any other questions? Okay. Thank you, Stefan, for your presentation.